I blew it. I truly blew it. In 1960, Marshallville became a town with water. As mayor at the time, I'm proud to say I was instrumental in getting the waterworks to town. No more outhouses and public taps. No more hauling buckets of water in and toilet pails out. Soon everything would be up to date. Hot and cold running, flushing and showering. That summer, streets and yards were torn up all over town as the infrastructure for water and sewer went in. And then, in early October, most of the town showed up for a ceremony to celebrate the arrival of the waterworks. New towns with water usually hold a subdued ceremony with a symbolic burning of an outhouse to signal the end of the old, well-worn path out back and the beginning of a bright, sanitary, indoor future. Never a town to do anything in a small way, the council and myself voted on burning all the biffies in town at once. There was one dissenting voice, Mark Robbins. He's now the mayor. Anyway, 171 outhouses were piled on the flats over at the north end of the lake, hauled and stacked by Dreger's Huff. The bottom openings, which once shielded holes filled with human muck, now gaped obscenely and odorously in plain view. Not the most pleasant sight as you drove into town. The local paper asked me for a comment about the forthcoming celebration, and my exact words still echo through my memory. It will make a fine blaze and leave an indelible impression. People will remember this night. At the ceremony, I gave a brief speech. Dr. Galt, in his British accent, remarked how a new era in our ability to fight disease and improve personal hygiene was beginning. I turned on a giant red tap. The water flowed in. The waste flowed out. It was a miracle. The 20th century had arrived. Everyone cheered. Then Fire Chief Burley lit the outhouses. More cheers as our paths went up in smoke, cutting a swath of light, heat, and stink through the cold October twilight. It was a fine blaze, enjoyed on many levels, but the outhouses had their revenge. That night, and for 3 days and nights afterwards, every nose in Marshallville knew we had the waterworks by a constant reminder. An acrid, burning manure smell that arose from the smoldering heap of collapsed outhouses. The smell resisted arduous spraying from the town's fire truck and produced a rank odor that permeated the whole town, no matter which direction the wind blew. It was awful. Some older people even went to the hospital for oxygen and relief. In the aftermath, I bore the brunt of coffee shop condemnation. I couldn't even go for a Java at Jim Jim's without being taunted, often not good-naturedly. But I was the one who said it would be a night to remember, and it stuck. Unable to claim the waterworks as my victory because of the blowback from the bad idea fire, I was soundly defeated the following year. Marshallville had flushed me. Even to this day, every time I flush the toilet, I can smell the stink from the burning outhouses. Apparently, this still happens to other people in Marshallville, too.